Hey guys, Ember Burns Black here, and I'm so excited. Halloween was yesterday, bringing a fantastic closure to spooky season, and now it brings us into the holiday season. So what I'd like to do for you guys is to have a nice couple segments of holiday dinners, big dinners, stuff you can do with your family and entertaining, and I'm going to do this for about the next 2 months. So today I'm going to try to make a very basic core to a Thanksgiving dinner, but instead of turkey, I'm going to be using chicken. So please remember to subscribe if you haven't already, and we're going to have a lot of fun. So the first thing I have done is I have this 6.4 pound chicken here, just pulled it out of the bag. So I'm going to check it, and it does have the bag of organs with it. I don't know my chicken anatomy perfectly, so I'm going to pull that aside. And I'm going to check the cavity, and it looks like there's nothing else in there. So now I'm going to check the other end. And there is nothing in the other end as well. So when I pulled this baby out of the bag, I did manage to find this. It is the instructions on it. Most packages of chicken will have that on it, so I'm going to keep that as a guide as I go along with this one. First thing I'm going to do, though, is I'm going to take these. Oh, why is that? Well, it's already sealed in the bag. Take these, and I'm going to start boiling them in a saucepan. So I'm going to take these organs, and I'm not sure. I don't really know what's what, but I'm gonna go ahead and put them in the bag. And then I'm gonna cover these with water. And I'm gonna go ahead and start boiling. This is actually a smaller pan than I want. I'm gonna put this back here, if I can tilt you. And I'm just gonna put that on high right now and let it simmer. And while I have this here, I'm just gonna let this chill. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make some spices, and I'm just going to make like a dry blend for my chicken. So I'm going to take the first ingredient I'm going to take is I'm going to take some breadcrumbs, and I'm going to use the breadcrumbs as a base. Make sure I have a lot of breadcrumbs. So those are my breadcrumbs. And with this, you can add basically anything and everything you want, which is really cool. I'm going to add some oregano, not a lot. And I am using seasoned breadcrumbs, so just a little bit of oregano. I'm going to use parsley. And then I'm going to be using minced onion on top of that. And again, you can use whatever you want. I'm going to use a little bit of clove, not a lot, just a little. Just give it that hint of clove. Some cayenne pepper. Again, not a lot. Just give it a little bit of kick. I'm going through my spice cabinet right now, picking and choosing what I put on. I'm going to use some sage, not too much, because the sage is strong and it will overpower. So, and a lot of these are the same color, so it's going to be hard to see on the screen. Using a little bit of garlic powder. Okay. And I did use minced onion rather than onion powder. The reason is I do kind of want the chunks. I'm going to use some mustard on here. Remember, I used a lot of breadcrumbs, the breadcrumbs on my base. I got some thyme. I'm using a little more thyme than a lot of the other stuff because I do want that taste. Pepper. I just a wee bit of cilantro, not a lot. And then I have a lemon pepper. I'm gonna use a little bit more lemon pepper than I did the other things, because I really do want that taste of lemon pepper. And then I'm going to add some paprika. And again, you can add whatever seasonings you like. This is just what I choose to use. But this is going to be the base on my skin in a bit. Now while I have this going back here, it is starting to foam. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to dump some of that. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put this bouillon cube in it. Hope it will calm down in a bit. I think I'm going to have to find a bigger pot for it in a second. Yeah, I need a bigger pot for that. This back here was getting a little too hot for itself, so I went ahead and put this in a bigger pan. And I'm still working on my little season bowl over here. So my phone just fell out of the cradle. I might have just lost my footage. I'm not sure, it's not loading. The battery completely came off my phone. So if it is corrupted, what I did the last segment was I spent the time and I made a spice thing. I have the organs out of my chicken and I have them boiling, and I have my chicken here that I'm still preparing. So next, since I have that going on, and like I said, I turned my oven on to 425. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna prepare an onion and a garlic. Now I went ahead and I diced my onion. I could have actually just chopped it and left it in bits, but next I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna chop this garlic. Okay, now that I have my onion and garlic all chopped up, I'm actually going to take a good piece of the garlic and I'm going to take some of the onion and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put it in this pot that I have my chicken organs cooking in. So now that I have my bird ready, I have my seasonings. Again, if the footage doesn't show up, you can use whatever you want. I just made myself a season blend. The base is breadcrumbs. I'm using seasoned breadcrumbs. So now that I got my chicken here, I'm gonna go ahead and I am going to start by the inside out as I pack it. And like I said, I made sure that cavity is nice and clean. First thing I'm gonna do is I gotta wash my hands again because I can't get a jar open. Is I am using some pickled sushi garlic and a clean fork, and I'm just gonna lay that inside my bird. And the reason I'm putting it inside is I wanted to kind of rotate around and get that ginger flavor in there. I'm gonna give it a drink of some what's this here sauce. Just pour that up in there, put it up its butt, let it get it in faster. And then I'm gonna take some lemon juice and I'm gonna do the same thing. Just squeeze that up in there and shake it all up. Garlic and onion mixture that I made, and I'm gonna mix it all up with my hand, which I'm doing off camera, and I apologize for this because I want it to be evenly mixed between onion and garlic. And I'm going to pull the skin off slightly, make a little pocket in here, because you definitely want to get the breast. The breasts are the juiciest parts of the chicken, or in a couple months, well, a couple days from now, your turkey. So I'm just pulling this up, making a nice pocket, making sure my fingers touch and I can get in there. Because that's half the fun of the turkey and the chicken both, is seeing what you can cram and where. And I'm just gonna shove this under the skin. Shove it up, make sure that boob is covered because it's gonna cook and flavor that boob. And I know I dropped a piece somewhere. Oh, it's already in the burner. And then I wonder why my burner's catch fire. Okay. Get that all up in there. Right in between the skin and the meat. That's what I said, you don't have to really... don't have to really make sure that you get it all diced. Big pieces can help too. So it has now been 30 minutes with my chicken on 425. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna scooch this chicken down to 375. And I'm gonna keep that on for 65 minutes. So now that I got the chicken on for 65 minutes, I have six spuds here, potatoes, all russet, some baby ones that I'm not gonna use, and some nice sized ones with two elephant ears of garlic. I'm just gonna wash these up and peel this garlic. Okay, now that I got my garlic peeled, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna cut the tips off of these. Next, I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna wash and scrub these potatoes. Okay, now that I got my potatoes washed and scrubbed, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to quarter these. Now that I have the potatoes quartered, I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna put them in this pot along with the full cloves of the elephant garlic. Like make them as fit best I can. Sometimes you can, sometimes you can. It's what it is. It is all good. I'm putting in the bigger pieces first. And the reason I'm trying to get it close to the bottom is one, I don't wanna use a bigger pan. And two, I just want to get this done. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to fill up the top with water. So now that I have everything completely submerged in water, I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to put this on high. This on high, I have also have this that I have boiled down into liquid. I'm going to strain that soon. And like I said, once this comes to a boil, I'm going to leave it boiling for 25 minutes. So it has been 25 minutes. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to strain these potatoes. Potatoes back on, you hear it sizzling because it's burning off the rest of that liquid. I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna add some butter and milk. With the butter, I'm just gonna add, I don't know how much this is, but about 2 spoonfuls on one, and let that kind of like cook into what I have. What I have is I have the pot turned off right now, but the burner is still hot, and I'm just letting the heat evaporate the rest of the moisture on my potatoes. Next, I'm gonna add some milk and I'm just gonna fill it until it looks like I've covered the whole bottom of the pot of potatoes. There we go, just like that. Now at this point in time, I have less than 20 minutes left on that chicken. So now I'm just gonna start mashing. So now that I have my potatoes mashed, the butter has given them a beautiful yellow color, but I still don't like my straight white potatoes. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to add some chives and parsley and kind of color it up some. Just a little bit of chives and the parsley. That will give it a beautiful green color. Throw that in. There are my mashed potatoes. So now that I have my mashed potatoes done, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to start on some stuffing. Okay guys, it has been the 65 minutes. I got my potatoes done. I have my stuffing done. My chicken is up to over 170 degrees. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm going to transfer my chicken over. So I'm just gonna use a skewer here and then pull it up underneath, being very careful not to burn myself. And it is stuck to the bottom. No, it's not. Yes, it is. Okay, next, if you remember, I did save all the organs. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to strain this, pulling both the onion and piece of garlic out. See all that deliciousness? And just toss that. I'm going to scrape this for any leftover seasonings, anything that is in this pan. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put it in that pot. Now, I did add some hot water to this, and that's because there wasn't enough for what I really wanted. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm turning this on high, and it's got what's in the pot and what's from the parts of the chicken, and I just want to get it to a boil. Let me... Okay, my chicken leftovers are starting to slightly boil, so before it gets way too hot to handle, I'm going to add just a wee bit of cornstarch. Now, I've never used cornstarch in gravy before. I'm anxious to see how it works, and it was recommended to me, so I'm going to add just a little bit of cornstarch, and then I'm going to add some flour. I got the flour and cornstarch in. I'm gonna whisk it. I'm gonna whisk it pretty hard. And the cornstarch, I actually like. It actually made a very thick gravy. It's a little, that is way thicker than I wanted, but it's gonna work out. Now, the gravy's pretty thick right now, and that's kind of how I want it tonight. I really like some thick gravy. Oh, that's actually turning out very, very nicely. So I'm gonna go ahead, try this, and it's got a nice consistency to it, if you can see that. Oh, I forgot to turn it off. Hello. So you want to definitely turn it off. So next I have my chicken here, and I know a pizza pan is not the best serving plate, but it is what I have. I'm really excited. I haven't been able to use this yet. I found an electric knife at the thrift store for a dollar, and I already plugged it in. It works. I just, like I said, have not been able to use it yet. And, you know, the cheapest, you never know what you're going to find. Always put your blades in before you plug it in. Just be safe. There we go. So I'm going to crack this breast right down the middle. Perfect. Next, I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to pull off this leg. There we go. So I got a beautiful leg. I'm gonna go ahead and make one kid's plate. Let this leg sit here for a minute. All right, so I have a chicken leg here with some of these beautiful mashed potatoes. A ladle of this gravy. Which is super, super thick, but as delicious. And then some of this glorious stuffing that I have made. And again, for Thanksgiving dinner or whatever holiday dinner you decide to host this season, this is just a base that's super easy. It took me a while. You can add, delete, subtract, multiply, whatever you want. And again, I used a chicken just because I don't want to get turkeyed out. So I got some stuffing on that plate. Now I'm going to add a little more gravy because I have enough gravy to go around, baby. And there you go. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Ember Burns Black. It means a lot to me. Stay beautiful, stay amazing, stay gorgeous. I can't even think right now. I'm tired. I did a lot of work. Anyway, I love you guys. Remember to subscribe. If you like what I do, support me. Patreon, PayPal, and Cash App are all in the description, all Ember Burns Black, as well as TikTok and my Amazon wish list. Thank you so much again. Bye. By the box stuffing. I like savory herb.